Here's three reasons you might not be getting the most out of your Google Workspace subscription. Hi there, my name's Pete Moriarty, and we help small business owners with their technology, making sure you have the right strategy in place to grow a successful business. Now, we typically work with business owners who are working online and in the cloud with Google Workspace and a host of other cloud applications. So if you're new to the channel, please take a look around and check out our growth roadmap, where we take business owners through the different stages of business, no matter where you are right now, giving you the right technology strategy to help you and your business succeed. Now, let's talk about some reasons why you might not be getting the most out of your investment in Google Workspace. Now, for us, we've worked with literally thousands of customers in the Google Workspace arena, and we are the top Google partner for small businesses right across Australia and New Zealand, which is pretty cool. And in over 10 years of business, we've seen the same thing happen over and over and over again, which is businesses who have set up themselves on Google Workspace, or maybe they were set up by a web hosting provider, or maybe they were set up by the person who built their website, and they kind of like understand a little bit about how the system works, but have this deep-seated feeling in underneath the surface that they're not quite getting the most out of the platform. And so I want to take you through some of the reasons why that might be and what you can do about it. Now, for the most part, for most people who are just given a piece of technology, they're not really, let's say, geeking out about it. And I completely understand it. Quite often when someone says, okay, I'm going to set up some email addresses for you, if you're in an early stage of business, you probably just want to get up and running and get off to the races. Now, other scenarios might be you initially had a Exchange or maybe Mac Mail set up, and at that point you decided to make the switch over to Google, but the person who was helping you do the switch, or maybe you even did the switch yourself, was not a professional with Google Workspace. So some of the things that happen there is there are features that sometimes are not switched on. There are things that are incorrectly configured. And sometimes you may not even know that features exist inside the Google Workspace ecosystem. Some of the most common things that we see are customers who are using something like Slack instead of using Google Chat, even though Google Chat has pretty much all the features that Slack has. Some customers are not utilizing Google Meet and instead opting to use Zoom instead. Again, you're missing out on features that are there inside the Google ecosystem. Next, we have customers who have not correctly configured their DNS settings. And so maybe your SPF or DKIM or even your DMARC records are incorrect. Now, they sound like technical terms because they're technical. They're the kind of thing that an IT person who is a professional will usually set them up for you correctly. But if they're not done correctly, and unfortunately many businesses who work with us have not got them figured correctly, well, your emails can end up in people's spam mailboxes. And we all know that's not good if you're trying to reach out to a prospect or a customer, or especially doing cold emails. We don't want emails in spam. If these are the kind of things that are coming up for you, or you're wondering, I'm using Zoom, or I'm using Slack, or sometimes my emails go to people's spam, well, it may be an issue with how things have either been set up in the back end of your workspace, or possibly just a matter of how it was implemented to your team. Were your team sold on the vision of why Google Workspace is a good platform to use and everyone using Google's tools happily? Or were they just kind of like given a login and told to go and work it out themselves? So that's the biggest one, is incorrect setup. And we're going to talk about a few other things that might be happening. Now, number two is, for many businesses, when Google Workspace is configured, it's not actually configured for rapid release. Now, rapid release is something that is in the administration panel. And when you tick this box, what that actually allows you to receive is the most up-to-date Google updates as they are rolled out. Now, if you don't tick this option, you may be waiting weeks or even months for new features that Google releases to be rolled out to your account. Now, you may think this is a small thing, but what tends to happen, and we've seen this in many business owners, is they read something on a blog about a new exciting feature that Google is bringing out, and they get all excited about it. Oh, wow, Google's going to roll this out to their customers in a matter of days. And weeks later, the feature still doesn't appear, and business owners get a little bit disheartened that they haven't received the feature in their Google account, and they go along their day about their business, and they forget about it. Now, the reason for that is, if you're stuck on the standard release or the slow release, well, you just don't get features at the same time as everybody else does. And so when you switch to rapid release in the administration panel, well, that means you're going to get the latest features as they come up. It's also a good idea for you to actually spend time checking out the updates blog, because the updates blog is where Google will actually let you know when new features are being released. And they will tell you the exact dates, or at least within a week, of when they're being rolled out, whether it's the rapid release or the standard scheduled release. So good ones to keep a tab on. Number three, the biggest challenge we see is business owners spending time in the business rather than on the business. And that basically means business owners are head down worrying about sales, worrying about marketing, worrying about income generation, and they're not really worried about the operations of the business or making sure things are running smoothly. Now, I've seen this all the time and I've been on my own journey of entrepreneurship where for me, it was more important at times to be focusing on what was coming in the front door. But I found that each time I did that and I neglected the operations of the business and actually making sure the technology systems were in place, the team were well organized, everyone had the right tasks delegated to them, they had the right tools in their hands to be able to perform with productivity and make sure that each team member was collaborating and working well together, well, the business started to suffer. And so if you're not taking care of the back end of your business, what can tend to happen is you're growing the business on the front end and you just throw more people at the problems of the back end of the business. And it's very easy to do that, but it's not efficient to do that. Because what ends up happening is as your business grows and scales, your fixed costs actually just scale with the variable costs of the business. And you don't end up with more net profit at the end of the day. So there's three recommendations that I have for you on how you can work on this, how you can get more value out of what you have inside of Google Workspace. Now, number one is subscribe to information and education. Read the updates blog for Google Workspace, making sure you're getting up to speed on all of the updates as they're released for the updates in the Google Workspace land. Number two, you want to make sure that, well, this is number two of part one. You want to make sure that you're subscribed to this channel. So if you haven't already, drop a click down below and hit the subscribe button and you will get access to all of our latest videos as they come out. Step number two, the actual step number two, is to check the insights panel in your administration panel of your Google Workspace account. The admin insights is going to give you access to who's using what, how much each part of the Google Workspace system is being utilized. And you may find some surprising results in there about, you know, how many meetings are being had either on the Google platform or off the Google platform. You may notice that some applications like Google Chat are being used less than you'd like them to be used. And this gives you an opportunity to both train and bring your team on board to doing things the Google way. Now, we don't say do everything the Google way just for the sake of it. What we do know is that teams that better utilize Google Workspace are more productive and are more likely to have a business that is more successful because their teams can collaborate with an efficient technology system and they are not going to have the perils of subscription overwhelm and a million different apps to log in for everyone. Now, number three, and this one's a little bit self-serving, but come along for a free account audit with ITGenius. If you're a Google Workspace user and you're interested in getting more out of the platform, well, we've got a free offer available for some business owners. If you're eligible, click on the link below to fill out the form to see if you are, and that is for a free Google account audit. We'll check out your Google account, let you know if you've set up anything incorrectly, check those DNS records for you, and make sure that everything has been configured as it should be. Now, the other thing we do is for our concierge members is we actually help to roll out and implement the latest features of Google Workspace as they come out. Is there a new app released? Well, we're going to get in touch and let you know that we can help you roll it out. Is there a new cool way that we've found to use Google Chat or a bot that we can add in there? Well, we're going to reach out to you too and let you know. So if you're interested in getting more out of Google Workspace, we are the experts in this for a small business. So jump on the link below and you can access our team either via the consult or via our transfer in offer. Now, our transfer in offer helps businesses on Google Workspace get access to our Google library, which is a classroom full of training videos for you and your team to get the most out of the Google platform. And you get access to our support team for adding and removing users and a helpful support bot as well. I'll see you on the other side. And if you'd like more videos like this, make sure you're subscribed and check out the playlists in our channel for more videos. No matter what stage of business you're at, we're here to help with your tech. See you soon.